You lefties.
Yeah.
I'm catching them in the face.
Yeah, I forgot to tell you that was the left hand. It puts
them in real tight.
Not bad. Very smooth.
All right.
Hello guys, this is JJ with Gear-Report.com, and we're bringing you guys a little bit of a review here for you guys. A couple of things we're going to start out with. This is the Gibbz Arms G4 side charge upper. This is on their left-handed version, and the charging goes opposite side, so you actually charge with your right hand, and of course it ejects out the left side, so it makes it the left-handed one. A couple of the other things that we're going to mention over here is we built this upper with Bear Creek Arsenal heavy profile barrel with the diamond flutes, and it's in a 1/8 223 wild chamber. The handguard is the JP Enterprises MK3 12.5 inch rapid configuration tube handguard, and JP Enterprise JP adjustable gas block system that is inside here, guys. We have a Roush stainless gas tube, R&J Firearms keg muscle brake. We also have this installed on the lower. The lower, of course, right now we're using is the WMD guns, the Beast. They have the little Beast and the big Beast. This is the Beast, which is the 223. And it's Nivix coated, everything. It's a completely Nivix coated lower, even the buffer tube is coated. The trigger group is coated also. And guys, another item that we have from WMD guns is the new black Nivix coated bolt carrier group. And this is, I have it over here to give you guys a difference in between the bolt carrier group that you have to use in the Gibbz Arms uppers and the standard one, which I'll show you guys here in a little bit. The other item that we're showing you guys in this review, in this video, that are not necessarily related to the build itself, it's more to the scope. We have the scope coat. This is a neoprene scope coat, pretty heavy neoprene to protect your scope. It's about 6 millimeters. This is the, as you see, XP6 black jacket. All right, guys. And underneath that, of course, we're seeing the scope now. We have a Lucid Optics L5 rifle scope in 4x16 in 44 millimeter optic. Okay. And we have UTG scope mounts, the 30 millimeter low profile LE grade Picatinny QD rings. And we have it because it's the low profile. You guys know that whenever you're using a scope on some of the ARs and AR-10, AR-15s, if the scope is too close to the top of the rifle, you might have issues being able to pinch your cheek against this, the stock enough to see through the scope. So we put it up on a half-inch riser, and that gave us the clearance, the optic clearance that we needed to see through the scope without issues. So now, I'm gonna show you guys over here. I'm gonna take out the bolt carrier here for you. So you see, this is one of the proprietary things that you gotta use for the Gibbz Arms uppers. When you see the pin that holds your extractor and the pin holder over in the bolt carrier, they use a different kind of bolt carrier pin on it. It has a shoulder, if you wanna put it that way. Has an extended higher portion on the pin, and that is part of what makes your side charge possible on their design. Their design is non-reciprocating, so once you charge the upper, you're able to just push the charging handle forward, and it'll stay there. And another thing that is also worth mentioning, since it's a side charge, then there would be an opening on the back where you would have your normal charging handle. And what they do is they have a cover for it. So you have to pin the cover down and push it onto your lower, and then you pin your lower in, and that covers up the port where your regular, where your standard charging handle would be at. Okay? So there you have it, guys. We also have our custom gear report sock on our magazine. When it comes to the functioning of the upper, we haven't had issues with the functioning of the rifle itself. We've been able to shoot it pretty good. The only thing that we have noticed on some of the ammunition that we have loaded, so our reloaded ammunition, sometimes if that those cases are not resized properly, and you get a case that is not pushing all the way through into the chamber, there is not any way to push or assist, do the push button assist that helps you close the chamber on the rifle. So you'll have to pull that round out of the chamber and, you know, reload again. That's one of the only things that we've noticed that would be good to have in an upper like this, that, you know, forward assist on the bolt. Other than that, if you guys are thinking about, you know, well, is there a right-handed, since we are showing you the left-handed version, yes, of course, there is a right-handed version. We are really happy to say, or at least I am, that they do make the left-handed version, which everybody that shoots left-handed, especially on a semi-automatic gun, you'll be used to having the cases fly over your face, in front of your eyes whenever you're shooting. This gets rid of that problem. It's very nice to shoot. It's interesting now, I can actually take the farthest left table whenever we go shoot and nobody's getting my brass in their face next to me. So the guys are actually kind of glad that I'm shooting on that side. Like I said, we have not had issues with this build, and we're going to continue using it. It's one of those items that has been good to us, and we'll continue using it and testing it, and see how the wear and tear goes out years after now. There you have it, guys. I said, you know, you have your rifle, and now the good thing with this sight charge, you're able to keep your trigger hand, then you charge with your right, you let go. Of course, I don't have any ammo in here, so it will not cycle. There you go. But you ready to go? We appreciate you guys.